And hello, my name is Peter Lesa. I'm from Vanuatu and I'm a Baha'i. One of the teachings of Baha'u'llah, the prophet founder of the Baha'i faith, he teaches that there is only one God, we all worship one God, and the unity of races.
In each island of Vanuatu, we have our traditional beliefs in which we've been believing in the gods for many, many years. We have a legend about the gods in these various islands of Vanuatu. Especially where I come from on the island of Tana, we believe that there is a god that exists long before. And we have had these principles of respect, we have had these principles of obedience, and it's already there. So when the Baha'i faith comes in with all these teachings, it is not very hard for the friends out there to see the teachings that go in line with the teachings of their traditional belief. That's why we have so much of them. And on these other islands, we have the same. They've been experiencing this same attitude of feeling, and we have a common belief here. Find in the remote places of the island of Sanda, we have the Baha'is far, far out in the bush. People who still live in the traditional way of life, and they still believe in the traditional way. So this is something that goes with them.
The Baha'i chief was saying that he doesn't want the dancing tonight to be spoiled by people who drink alcohol and come here and doing mischief around here. He doesn't want it. And he wants everybody to be happy as they are, no drinking alcohol, no nothing, no alcohol.
When they receive the message of Baha'u'llah, put it in together and it fits in somewhere. And that's how most of you have find that they are very, very, very spiritual people out there, and they believe in the teachings of Baha'u'llah.
The Baha'i community really is following what the world governing body of our faith, the Universal House of Justice, would like us to do. Now, just at the moment, it's placing emphasis on what we call the four core activities. The first of these is our study circles, which mean that you study the pure writings of the faith. The second is the concentration on children's classes, on exposing our children to the pure word of God, and also developing their capacities, their virtues, their capacities for service as well. Another core activity is the junior youth. Very heavy emphasis here on service, giving service to others. And the fourth core activity is, of course, devotional meetings, having prayer meetings where people come together and share prayers. The important thing about these core activities is that we must have them available for everybody. It's not just for the Baha'i community, it's for everybody. And here in Vanuatu, we're really trying to do this. Now, for example, you're watching now a study circle which we're running at the Teachers College. And this study circle has been running for a couple of years now. We come together every Tuesday evening, and most of the people who come haven't yet declared themselves as Baha'is. They're very happy to come. They like the writings of the faith. They like the atmosphere of the study circle. And they like the music that we sing.
God has a plan for me.
That's why he created me. From the book, I don't think we are just created by mistake or whatever. Like, there's a plan for us being created. So I think there are a lot of good words in the book that help us, or help me especially, to understand why I am being created.
So we have study circles which provides us the chance, opportunity to go more deeper into the teachings of Baha'u'llah. And as he says, the more deeper you go into the ocean of my words, the more you will find. And this is what we are trying to do when we get together as a group once a week, twice a week, and we can try to understand a prayer or a holy writing.
You start off with book one, which is looking at the Baha'i writings, looking at the importance of prayer, and looking at life being a spiritual side and a material side, and continuing on after you pass away. You then move on to book two, which is arising to serve, giving service. Book three, focusing on children's classes. Book four, giving you a better understanding of the lives of the twin manifestations, Baha'u'llah and the Bab. Book five, which is focusing on how we help animators, as we call them, to develop the power, the powers, the skills, the capacities of junior youth. That means those who are between 12 and 14. Book six is focusing on how we share the faith, how we teach the faith to others, because, you know, in the Baha'i faith, everybody is a teacher. There's no pastors, there's no special people to do it. Everybody has the responsibility and the honor, the privilege of sharing the words of Baha'u'llah. Well, here on Ifate, we've got a number of groups who are having these junior youth classes. Remember, these are young people between the age of 12 and 14. We've driven out from Port Vila, and we park the car on the main road. Then we have to walk up this muddy track for about a kilometer to one of the family's houses. We collect some of the junior youth on the way, and they often bring other people with them. When we get there, we sit down together, we have a few prayers. The person, the actual animator, is Willie. And Willie is a youth, Baha'i youth, very strong in the faith, and he is officially in charge. Inside this book are a number of stories from Africa, or in one case, in the second book, it's about somebody from, I think probably from Rwanda, who faces great difficulties. His mother and father are killed, and you follow his story through these, through the different villages as he escapes, and he has to decide for himself, does he become like everybody else and fight everybody, or does he stand up and try to promote unity and work for the unity of the different groups together? And so this whole book is about that. And in studying these books, the junior youth become aware of character training, they become aware of the virtues and important things such as that.
Are very simple, but inside it there's a there's a depth of meaning that we enable the children to begin to comprehend what they read. One of the beauties of this is it also teaches them or assists them in their schoolwork. So we're finding children now who may have come 15, 16, out of a class of 28, who after the first book are coming third, second place. And that's the power of expression, of reading and comprehending what you are reading. We learn prayers, we learn some of the teachings that's going to help you become a good person. One of the first lessons is truthfulness is the foundation of all human virtues. So we can go throughout life, but if we don't tell the truth, we are going to face problems. So this is what we teach the children, the youths at a very young age, and we practice that. And so this is one of the beauties about teaching them, catching them at that early age, so that it sets a foundation for their spiritual life in future.
Bahá’u’lláh gave us a system for organizing the community from local level to national level to world level. It's like an embryonic world order. And we call this the Baha'i Administrative Order. Now, basically at each level, we have a series of councils or assemblies. For example, at the local level, people in a village or a town come together once a year in April, and they elect their local spiritual assembly. At a national level, the local communities all choose delegates, and the delegates come together at a national convention to choose their national spiritual assembly. And then once every 5 years, every member of every national spiritual assembly in the world, they come together, usually at the Baha'i World Center, if that's possible, and they elect the Universal House of Justice. Now what you're seeing now on the film is what happened this year at National Convention for Vanuatu. And National Convention this year took place at Lenaco in Tana. We had 38 delegates drawn from different parts of Vanuatu, different units of the country. They came together over one weekend, and what you're watching is the way they are carrying out two basic functions of the National Convention. The first one, they are electing the 9 members of the National Spiritual Assembly of Vanuatu for the coming year. They can elect anybody in the country who is an adult over 21, male or female. The second function of the delegates is to consult on the affairs of the Baha'i community and the promotion of the basic ideals of the faith, which is to achieve unity. They consult through a process of consultation where everybody shares their feelings and they pass their recommendations to the incoming National Spiritual Assembly. Now the convention goes ahead over a 2 or 3 day period. In the evenings on Tana, everybody comes to watch and to support and to sing, and you're seeing on the film now what we call a 19-day feast, where, you know, every 19 days all the Baha'is in the area come together to celebrate like the regular meeting of the community. So what you're watching here is people singing and enjoying and saying prayers, and you'll even see a string band. The string band is actually singing some of the words of Baha'u'llah put to music. When election takes place, there is no canvassing. There is no going around and saying, well, vote for me, or let's vote for that person. Everybody has the sacred duty to elect whoever he or thinks best has the qualities to serve on the assembly. And the delegate goes in a corner, he reflects, he prays, and then he writes down 9 names on a piece of paper. These names are put into a box. The names of the delegates are called out. They come in one by one and they put on their vote into the box. They count them up, and whoever gets the most votes is elected onto the National Spiritual Assembly.
But in this center, we have the National Spiritual Assembly office here. It is the regional Baha'i office for the NSA.
it's very unique, this administrative system, because you don't find this anywhere else in other administrative system. But this system here is a divine system which has been erected by Baha'u'llah, who is the prophet founder of the Baha'i faith.
During this 1 week, the junior youth of two local Baha'i communities came together to raise funds. They went to collect coffee beans, which were dried, and later they will be sold to raise funds to send members of the National Spiritual Assembly of the Baha'is of Vanuatu over to Haifa next year to elect the Supreme Governing Council of the Baha'i faith in Israel. Because it's very expensive, the junior youth are contributed in raising the funds. All the National Spiritual Assemblies in the world will be sending their 9 members. There are over 200 of them, and they will send the members over to Haifa to elect the 9 members of the Supreme Council, the Supreme Governing Council of the Baha'i faith. I myself am a National Spiritual Assembly member of the Baha'is of Vanuatu, and I have taken the responsibility to raise money for my trip. It will take a lot of money, but I'm trying my best, and if God's will, I'll be present at this election, and I'm looking forward to go. It will be my first time.
Whenever you have a friend from New Zealand come to Vanuatu, we will just talk about the same thing, and the same activity we will do in Vanuatu is the same activity he will be doing at home. And that's a particular thing that is very important about the Baha'i faith, is that we have the same point of view and same aim. And the aim is to be united, the humankind have to be united.
And also, as junior youth, we youth animators are helping them to realize the importance of self-employment. Because in Vanuatu, there are not many people who have jobs, so we help the junior youth to realize the importance of self-employment. Already some have planted their own coffee plants, which in about 5 years' time they will start picking the coffee beans and then they will sell them. We have been told to recycle this poly bag. It's very poisonous if you burn it. The smoke goes into the air and it's bad for our health. So we have been instructed to recycle it. So the junior youth studied 3 books. The first one is Breezes of Confirmation. The second one was Glimmerings of Hope. The third one is Walking the Straight Path. And throughout this week, they did some service act, which is in connection with those 3 books that they were studying. The whole purpose of this service act is to encourage the junior youth that when they grow older, they will do service to their family, they do service to their friends, and above all, they do service to humanity. That is one of the teachings of the Baha'i faith, for our kids to be trained in good deeds so that they can make this world a better place to live in.
Education of children is a priority. And they start right from when they're babies to when they're children and to the junior youths. And the Baha'is have recognized that the junior youth phase, which is ages between 12 and 14, 15, it's a time when there's a lot of changes in them. They go from a child to becoming a youth, and it's a time when they start to explore and experience. And this is a very good time to start teaching them some fundamentals. And some of the fundamentals are the spiritual side, because it's also the time when we experience with materialism. So you get caught up with peers and you start to drink alcohol or take drugs. And it's times like this when we need to insert in their lives something which is spiritual, in order to allow them to make a decision, which road shall I follow? So we in the Baha'i Faith have a program for junior youths. We have a number of courses which provides them with a spiritual empowerment to be able to express themselves. And one of the things that they can express is whether they want to go down that track or not. So we provide the writings, we go through readings of books that are written by Baha'is around the world, and it's been tested over many, many years.
Music is really important in the culture of all Pacific Islands, and certainly in Vanuatu. We have traditional music that goes back for thousands and thousands of years, and we have music that's come in from with the missions. We have the latest pop music that's coming in that young people love, reggae, rap particularly. And we have a style that's developed in Vanuatu called string band.
Father is saying that he was worried about his children because these days the society is facing some difficulties raising up the children in good behavior, good habits, and he was worried about his children. So when we told him about the Baha'i program, the Baha'i children's program, he was interested in it and he wanted to have a go at it. He is hoping that through the children's class, the children would learn some of the things that his old people, his old men, were teaching him a long time ago. His old men were teaching him about good habits, characters building, but nowadays this is missed out from the children. So he's saying that he's very happy to have the Baha'i children's class here, and he's hoping that one day these children will come up to be good people. And he said that if the program is good, he will talk to the other parents to make a bigger house, to make a special house in which children from other villages can come together to have the Baha'i children's class. A few months back or a few years ago, when the children come back from school, they just roam around. Sometimes she takes them to her garden, they come back, and during the night, some of them don't say any prayers and they sleep. In the morning, some of them wake up, they don't say any prayers. Now that this class has been going on here, now she, in the evening, she actually hears them praying before they sleep, and then when they wake up in the morning, they say their prayers before they come out. And she says that she's very happy. She's very happy that this children's class program is helping her to raise her children and her grandchildren.
The main thing that I really love is the equality of men and women. Baha'u'llah talks about the equality of men and women, the consultation and the cooperation between the family inside the family is really important to create a better home.
In our culture, women are very, very important. They are bridge builders. Through their marriages, they build bridges between families. This strengthens our unity and it makes us all live in harmony, in peace and in love, and we honor and we respect each other. The Baha'i wedding and the civil marriage registration should be done within 24 hours. It's an educational process for us here to educate ourselves in keeping the law. the law of the country and the law of our faith.
There are the social teachings, like women and men are equal. We all come from the same God, and that the religion is one. By looking at this, I think it's one of the things that can change the social life of the people here. It's the teachings of the Baha'u'llah that attracts me to the Baha'i faith. Like you talk about the oneness of mankind, and you talk about the equality of the women, and this really influenced my feeling, because in our traditional society, we are sort of male-dominated society, where the women have no saying in society, we have the men who dominate everything in the society. So this is one of the things that made me really touch my heart, and even the writings of Baha'u'llah.
Oh my God, unite the hearts of thy servants and fill to them thy great purpose. May they follow thy commandments and abide in thy law.
What is the purpose of a prayer? Prayer is communion with God, and you do it in a way that is respectful. And this is what I'm learning as a Baha'i, that when I'm praying, I'm talking with God, I'm communing with Him. And in order to do that, I must have respect. And so these are some of the things that I've learned to become a Baha'i. And that's what I'm saying, that it's totally changed the way I see things around me.
I didn't become a Baha'i because my father was a Baha'i. I do the readings myself, and I do my own investigation. And then when I was 15, I declared myself as a Baha'i.
And immediately, it enabled me to put everything together that I just witnessed from travelling. You know, all the religions are really one. And that what Baha'u'llah says is that they've all come for a different time in our history. On one occasion, I was given the Book of Certitude, written by Baha'u'llah, and I read this, and I kept reading all night. And in the morning, I just had to declare myself as a Baha'i.
Ha ha ha!